guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Maddie, and today I'm going to be sharing with you 15 books that I read in one day. And for this, I was very specific. Even if I read a book within 24 hours, if on Goodreads it says that I read the book over the span of 2 days on the calendar, then I did not include it on this list. Also, I didn't include books that were part of a series if they weren't the first book of the series. And then, of course, there's a ton of books that I read in one day, and I could not include all of them in one video, so I just picked 15 that I want to talk to you guys about and recommend them to you. First, I have The Thing with Feathers by McCall Hoyle. This is a YA contemporary romance story, and it features a disabled main character who has epilepsy, and she is starting public school for the very first time, and she decides it's best to keep her epilepsy a secret, but things kind of get complicated and kind of messy when the guy she is falling for and starting a relationship with doesn't know that she has epilepsy. I really enjoyed this representation, and while I cannot personally speak towards the accuracy of the representation, I did enjoy seeing it in not just a YA novel, but seeing a main character who has epilepsy. Next, I want to talk about Bird Box by Josh Malerman. This is an adult thriller horror novel, which I really enjoyed. I flew through it. I actually listened to the audiobook, and it was so atmospheric. It's almost a dystopian style world because these creatures have started inhabiting the earth, and if you look at one of these creatures, you either go on a killing spree and start murdering people, or you kill yourself. And so everyone must wear blindfolds in order to keep them safe and the people around them safe. If you like horror books or horror movies, I definitely recommend this one. Next, I have The Way I Used to Be by Amber Smith. This is one of my favorite books that I read this year. I loved it so much. This book is a YA hard-hitting contemporary, and it follows a teenage girl who was raped by her brother's best friend. He's kind of been considered part of their family for several years, and no one would suspect that he would do something like this, and so she decides to keep it secret. And this book follows the main character throughout high school as she just tries to cope with what's happened and the trauma that she's endured and the PTSD that she has. I actually study psychology because I want to be a therapist for people who have undergone sexual trauma, and in my opinion, this representation is amazing. Next, I have Everything Everything by Nicola Yoon, and this is one that I flew through. It was such an easy and quick read. However, I didn't enjoy it that much. So while I did read it in one day and I am recommending it to you, it wouldn't necessarily be a 5-star rating for me. But this is a YA contemporary story following a teenage girl who essentially is shut off from the entire world. She cannot go outside because she is allergic to everything, basically. But when a cute boy moves in next door and they start a texting relationship, the main character decides that maybe she wants to take her life into her own hands. Next, I have Flame in the Mist by Renee Audier. I love Renee Audier so much. I love their books. This is a YA fantasy novel inspired by Mulan, and it hooked me. The main character of the story is the daughter of a prominent samurai, and she is being betrothed to one of the crown princes. But on the way to the palace to meet her new betrothed, her carriage is attacked and she barely escapes with her life. And she decides to take revenge on the gang that attacked her by infiltrating their camp as a man. Next, I have The Lies About Truth by Courtney Stevens. And honestly, I don't remember a lot about this book, but it is a YA hard-hitting contemporary about a girl who was in a car accident with her best friend. And through their grief, the main character begins to bond with her dead best friend's brother. I read this book within a few hours. Next, I have Anna and the French Kiss by Stephanie Perkins. If you've been watching my channel for a while, you know how much I love this book. This is a YA contemporary romance story following a teenage girl who is forced to go to boarding school in Paris. And while she's there, she meets and befriends a cute French boy. Next, I have Shatter Me by Tahereh Mafi. This is one that I actually just reread, and I still loved it the second time around. I've talked a lot about this one on my channel recently, but if you don't know, this is a YA dystopian fantasy novel following a main character named Juliet, whose touch is lethal, and because of that, for the last few years, she's been kept in a prison. But one day, the government takes her out of prison, and they try to force her to work for them as a weapon. It's also heavy on the romance. Next, I have To All the Boys I've Loved Before by Jenny Han. I'm sure you all know what this is about too, but if you don't, it's a YA contemporary romance novel, and it follows a teenage girl who, throughout her life, whenever she had a crush on someone, she wrote them a love letter and then sealed it up and put it in a box and never mailed or gave the letter to them. But then one day these letters are somehow mailed out to all of her previous crushes. And so all of her crushes from her past and present start showing up in her life again. It's very cute and very fun. Next I have Vampire Academy by Rochelle Mead. This is one I read a long time ago, but this is a YA paranormal story following vampires, and there are three different kinds of vampires. There are the Moroi, who essentially are like normal vampires except they're not evil and they have magical powers, and then there are the Dampirs, who are only half vampire and they are essentially the bodyguards, the protectors of the Moroi, and then there are the Strigoi, who are the evil vampires who just kill everybody. This series follows two best friends. One is a Moroi royal and the other is a Dampir, and there's also a lot of romance in this series as well. Next I have Ruby Red by Kirsten Gier. This is actually a book written by a German author and the book was translated into English. This is a YA time travel romance story and the main character belongs to a family of time travelers. However, with each generation there is only one person who actually has this ability and they are trained their whole childhood to be able to time travel, and I believe it was the main character's cousin who has been trained to be the family time traveler. However, their predictions were wrong. It's a very cute romance. It also kind of feels like a historical fiction because you're going back and forth through time. I really liked this one, but it's been several years since I read it. Next, I have The Summer I Turned Pretty trilogy by Jenny Han. And yes, I said the whole trilogy. This is actually a bind up of all three books. And I read all three books in one night. I flew through them. I was so addicted. I could not stop reading. I loved everything about this series. I actually prefer this trilogy to the To All the Boys I Loved Before trilogy by Jenny Han. I love this series so much. This is a YA contemporary romance story, but it also has a heavy focus on family and found family, and I love that about this series. This story follows two different families in which the moms are best friends and always have been best friends, and they are essentially each other's family, and every summer they all get together and go to this summer beach house and spend the entire summer together. This book follows the main character Belly, but it also follows two brothers named Conrad and Jeremiah, and although they have always been like family, Belly has secretly always had a crush on the older brother Conrad. And then one summer Belly has grown up, and when she arrives at this beach house, both brothers, Conrad and Jeremiah, start to see Belly a little bit differently as more than just their little sister. Next, I have The Selection trilogy by Kira Cass, and again, I mean the entire trilogy. I read this entire trilogy within 24 hours. I started reading the first book one afternoon, and I kept reading all the books until like 5 o'clock in the morning the next day. This is a YA dystopian romance story, and in this series, America is now a monarch ruled by the king. And the prince is now become of age, and it's a tradition for the royal prince, whenever he becomes of age, to host this selection, and it's basically like The Bachelor. It's a competition in which like 24 girls are chosen to live at the palace while he tries to find a bride, and it's also like reality TV, so everything is filmed, and with like each week he has to eliminate one girl. This series is basically like The Bachelor but with royalty and set in a dystopian world. They're not the highest quality of literature, but they are so addicting. Next I had The Lightning Thief by Rick Riordan. This is book one in the Percy Jackson and the Olympian series. I actually just reread this past week as well. If you don't know, this is a middle grade fantasy story following a little boy named Percy Jackson who finds out that he is actually a demigod. He and his new friends have to go on several adventures to try and save the world, and it is such a fun time. This is a middle grade classic. If you haven't read it, you should probably read it by now, but no shame, no shame. And lastly, I have Clockwork Angel by Cassandra Clare. Cassandra Clare has always been my favorite author up until recently, but I still love her books. They're so nostalgic to me. If you are unaware, this is the first book in the Infernal Devices trilogy, and it is a part of the Shadowhunter Chronicles. Basically, Shadowhunters are half human, half angel, and they protect the human world from the demon world. They're essentially invisible demon slayers. There's also werewolves, vampires, fairies, and warlocks in this world. It's such a fun time, and all of her books have really cute and angsty romances. So if you like YA urban fantasy, you should definitely at least try one of her books. I recommend starting with the Infernal Devices because the general consensus is that this trilogy is better than the Mortal Instruments. I personally love them both. Alright, those are 15 books I read in one day. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more bookish content. content by me. Let me know in the comments down below if you have read any of these books and what your thoughts were on them. I hope y'all have a wonderful day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.